side word.
There was this guy in America.
Mm-hmm.
And he has just been lauded for as being a hero to the local community for helping put a kidnapper at bay. Now, before I go into it fully, there's a video that we're going to watch.
Yeah.
And then we'll come back and discuss it. Okay?
Okay.
All right.
And we're back.
Okay. So we just watched that video, right?
Right.
Now, this is the story.
Yeah.
So a guy.
Yes.
This is in New Mexico, by the way, Las Cruces. I don't know if I said that right.
Ah, yes.
So
it's not in Old Mexico, it's New Mexico.
New Mexico.
I don't think it's Old Mexico. I think it's just Mexico.
This offender.
Why would you have a New Mexico if you didn't have an Old Mexico?
Because
it's just Mexico New Mexico, yeah. Like England and New England, you know.
What's of New England?
It's
Siege.
So, Daniel Arroyo Beltran, 22-year-old, right, from Phoenix, basically comes across this family. So this mother had just got off the bus stop with her children, age 9, 2, and 1, and was waiting for an Uber to pick them up. And this guy, Daniel, comes, grabs the 2-year-old child, and then demands that the woman hand over her other kids as well to him.
Yeah.
I don't know if they know each other, but he's from Phoenix and like they were just doing minding their own business, right?
It could be relatives, like brother,
Could it be the dad?
No, maybe the dad's brother or something, some relative.
But why? But he would have had to been stalking them when they got off a bus. Like they just randomly got off a bus waiting for Uber. So he'd have had to know where they were.
Yeah.
And then like followed the bus.
Yeah, well, we've watched heaps of like crime movies and they don't just, you know what I mean?
You're right.
It sounds like Criminal Minds, like the guy was just...
sounds like Blacklist as well.
You're right. Yep. So he grabs the kids, scary, right?
Yeah.
That's what you see, the little scuffle happening in the top left corner of the screen. And then it moves into the petrol station or convenience store, wherever they are, and punches are thrown, blah, 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 blah.
Blood spilt
until this hero warrior...
Not all men wear capes. Oh, no, superheroes wear capes. Yep,
sure. Continue. Walks in the door. This guy, 16 years old.
He's 16?
16 years old high school student.
Wow.
His name's...
Dude, he had his veggies.
His name is Kanan Bauer.
I think he had more than veggies.
And...
bit of stories.
He is a wrestling champion.
Oh.
So he did, I think it said something like 125 kilo category...
125 kilos or pounds.
Made it at 16 years old.
Made it to state.
That is massive.
Wait, let me just see. It's 285 pounds, which is 129 kilos.
Wow.
Heavyweight division.
How tall is he?
Doesn't say. He must be tall. He won.
He looked pretty tall in the video.
He looked tall, eh? Yeah.
He won the District 3-5A championship and then made it to state.
So you know he was outside, right? And the guy's like, oh, there's a crazy guy outside. And the guy just opens and goes, yeah, I know.
Not even that. Guess what? I think he was on the other side of the road. That's where he lives. And he heard screams.
Yeah.
He gets in his truck, drives over, gets out and walks in.
That's incredible.
16 years old. Like what?
But that's like...
I'm surprised his name's not Bubba.
But I feel like if you're used to physical contact, constantly used to physical contact, it becomes more of a... instinct more than like you're not thinking about stuff. You're like, all right, I've been in these sort of situations before. How would I take this guy down?
So basically he comes in, this guy, Kanan.
Yeah.
And like his
name's Kanan.
Yeah. Well, I don't know.
The guy that came in is Kanan.
Yeah, the 16-year-old. I don't know if it's spelled C-A-N-A-A-N. So it's either Kanan or Kanane or Kanan. I'm thinking Kanan. I don't know.
I don't know how to say that.
Like all of those
Kanan
versions.
From Power.
I like Kanan.
How do you say it?
C-A-N-A-A-N. Surname Bauer or Boa. So he comes in and he makes hastily, because the guy, the offender's out of screen by now. He gets him, like obviously gets him to the floor, and then they come back into view of the CCTV. And he pins him down and he holds him down for what? A good...
Kanan.
What do you... Kanan.
Four or 5 minutes. He just...
Maybe 4 minutes or more until the police got there.
Yeah.
Just pinned him. He said he got him in a chokehold. We couldn't really see. But the dad of this Canaan guy was like, that's my boy. But he's like, I worry for him too, because the guy could have had a knife or a gun. You don't know.
Yeah. Yeah.
But like, seriously, 16 high school student, that's...
But he was so relaxed as well when he's on top of him. He was relaxed. Just like, he had all... But I guess the other guy, I'm guessing, is about 80, 90 kg. So he's not a small guy, but then you got 125 kg lying on top of you, and I know how to move the weight around.
Yeah.
You're not going anywhere. So this guy just put himself, he like got a nice side position. What's it called? Side position?
Side mount. Side control,
yeah. And then he's just looking around the store, like almost trying to keep everyone calm.
Yeah.
And then like you got the older women that are like, or the middle-aged women that have nearly lost their kids, or watch people nearly lose their kids, are trying to hit him with all sorts. Like they're trying to hit the guy that's pinned down with wet floor signs. One woman brings out a wine bottle or something. And don't know what she was planning on doing with that, but but he was so calm in the whole situation. And then at the end, he pats him on the back, right? It's fine, well done. And then gives him a hug. They're like, "Oh, thank you so much."
Yeah. You know what I'm impressed?
What a hero. There was an absolute hero.
The blood that was shed from this older guy's nose, no one stood in it. I thought, someone's going to stand in his blood. No one stood
in that.
That's
what you saw? Out of the whole, like, there was a lot of stuff happening there.
Stand in the blood.
And you're worried about the blood.
The poor bugger got hit.
I gotta give him props, right? That guy that got hit in the nose, he's like, I'm gonna get beat up here. He's like, I have no chance. Like,
yeah, because actually at the beginning, that old guy, he stayed back at the door. He stayed back because he didn't really want to get involved. But then when it came to the door, he had no choice. Yeah. Like, he's like, oh, far out, fine, okay. I'll try and hold the door closed. And then he gets a busted nose or something.
You know, there was...
Yeah. I think he was better off staying back.
There was a guy...
Just wait for Kanan.
There was a guy in Parramatta, right? And I think, like, similar to this, there was a guy, I think he stole something from the shop. It made the news. Anyways, this guy's running. And all of a sudden, like, this guy I knew in high school but didn't know. Like, you know Johnny Dang? Do you remember Johnny Dang? Mm. CJ?
I remember Johnny Dang, but I can't remember the face.
He's short.
I remember making fun of the last name.
Yeah, right. So this guy...
Going dang, da dang, da dang, da dang, dang.
He was like...
I remember that.
He was 5'2". This guy, there's nothing of him, right? But so he was so skinny in high school. But when I saw him that day, he had bulked up so much. This guy was like...
He was wide as much as
he was tall. This guy was just a unit, right? Anyway, this guy stole something or robbed a chick, and he was running around the robber was running around the corner, and Johnny Dang, he sees him, lines him up, and tackles him. Spear tackles him, bang, straight into the floor, holds him down until the cops come, right? And then they're trying to interview him, and he's like, no, I don't want to be on TV. No, and like,
oh, wow.
That's where I got that saying. Like, he goes, not all heroes wear capes.
Aww. Yeah.
But like, just because I saw him on the TV, and he was like, no, I don't want to be on TV. I know him.
Would you want to be on TV if you'd done a heroic thing? Or would you be like, no, someone bad's going to come for me now. Someone's going to say, I messed up their plot. Now they're going to come for
their
me.
Their plot. I don't know if everyone's a criminal mastermind.
It's not really a plot.
Yeah, I didn't get a very complicated plot put together there. Run into that petrol station and grab some kids.
It might
have got more complicated after that, but it seemed like a pretty novice sort of beginning, you know.
Well, this guy, Kanan, ever since this went down, this only happened like a couple weeks ago, actually. Mm. But he's been having now like at least 2 interviews a day. He's got like UFC president Dana White, mixed martial arts champion Henry Cejudo. And
I don't know that.
Jorge Masvidal, I don't know how to say these names. They've all been praising him. He's gonna have a nice career set up now, I think.
As a what?
Wrestler or MMA or something.
What are you setting him up like?
I don't know. Mm. But
poor buggers are
getting. I hope this is not the peak of his human existence.
Well, no.
It's not a bad peak. It's better than my peak so far.
It's better than not having any, I guess, for him, you know.
Not having.
Imagine the ladies at school.
Well, you could just see the ladies in the bottle shop.
If you Google image him, his name, you really actually see how young he is. Because you can't really tell in
this. What was his name?
Kanan, C-A-N-A-A-N.
That's it?
Bower.
You're just known by Kanan.
Bower, B-O-W-E-R.
Oh, man, he...
Oh, God.
Do you want to hear his name? CJ, you want to hear his name?
Kanan.
Yeah, what?
Kanan.
Kanan.
He looks like an
I know. Kid. So the Arroyo guy was charged with attempted kidnapping, 2 counts of child abuse, 4 counts of battery, 2 counts of assault.
Oh, no, he's a kid.
Yeah.
But he is huge.
Yeah, he's tall.
Have you seen him, the one in the Could in you? The aisle?
Yeah.
In the grocery aisle?
Yeah.
Yes.
Could you imagine going to prison knowing you just got stopped by a 16-year-old?
Yeah, but Siege, like if when you say 16-year-old, 6'8", 125 kilos, you go, it doesn't matter how young the guy is, man. Like 125 kilos, no, but 6'6".
In prison,
yeah,
they're gonna be like, so how old was he? 16.
Yeah.
Come sit beside me, sweetheart.
Sweetheart.
Thank you.